हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑन जंबल्ड सेगमेंट्स। आई एम हेयर टू हेल्प यू आउट टू अंडरस्टैंड द जंबल्ड सेगमेंट्स इन योर सेकेंड टॉपिक इन योर वर्कबुक। यू हैव सम एग्जांपल्स ऑन जंबल्ड सेगमेंट्स like your first year workbook. This year you are going to study the jumbled segments for 1 mark. That question will come in your last section. They are very easy to understand and make them meaningful sentences by remembering the formula called subject, verb and object. I am L.D. Ratnakar, lecturer in English. Now, what is a jumbled segment? Jumbled segment, the word jumbled means there are some words and phrases, they are not in an order, they are jumbled. And you have to rearrange those words and phrases to form a meaningful sentences. While arranging these jumbled words and phrases, you need to remember the subject. First of all, you have to identify where is the subject in that given sentence. Followed by that subject, remember the verb. And the last one is an object. This SVO formula you have to remember. Usually in these examples, you would get a slash between the words. Whenever you have such type of examples, you have to rearrange those words to form meaningful sentences. One example will come. And for more examples, you can refer your previous year question papers. On page number 3, you have 10 jumbled segments. Segments here means the sentences. Jumbled means these are the sentences, they are not arranged properly. That means they are jumbled. You have to rearrange them to form meaningful sentences. Look at your first example. This example they have done for you. Is it important to protect our environment? The correct sequence of this sentence is, whenever you have such type of example, read all the given words and phrases carefully. Try to understand the subject, verb and object of the given example. In this example, it is a subject. That subject is followed by a helping verb. It is important to protect our environment is the correct given example. With the help of this example, now you have to rearrange the given words in order to form a meaningful sentence. First sentence is, own every its language country has. Here there are 6 words. With the help of these words, you have to form a meaningful sentence. Here the subject must be every. Every country has its own language is the correct sentence. Second one, divided countries, continents, the is into and world. There are 7 words. If you rearrange all these words, the meaningful sentence would be, the world is divided into continents and countries. Third one is, humility, a lot, simplicity, with to do. In your workbook you have different example, very deforestation to be can prove damaging to Mother Earth. Look at this third example, deforestation should be your subject. Deforestation can prove to be very damaging to Mother Earth. That is the correct sentence. Fourth one is, should each individual, his on plant a tree birthday. The correct sentence is, each individual should plant a tree on his birthday. Fifth one is, to keep we encourage must the earth green, afforestation. The correct sentence is, we must encourage afforestation to keep the earth green. Sixth one is, humility, a lot of simplicity has with to do. Simplicity has a lot. The correct one is, simplicity has a lot to do with humility is the correct one. Seventh one is, used as a to highlight, newspapers are powerful weapon, social problems. Newspaper is a subject here. Newspapers are used as a powerful weapon to highlight social problems. Eighth one is, sports and business world in the also ripe in corruption of. The meaningful sentence is, corruption is ripe in the world of sports and business also. Ninth one is, rules certain and regulations follow must we. There is a pronoun. It should be its subject. We must follow certain rules and regulations. And the last one is, old people, helpful, kind and to should be one. The correct sentence of the last example is, one should be kind and helpful to old people is the correct sentence. These are the 10 examples you have in your workbook. You write appropriate numbers below these words. With the help of these 10 examples, refer some previous year question papers. In the last section, you would get such kind of example. Arrange them meaningfully. While arranging those sentences, you have to remember the simple formula, that is the construction of a sentence. Subject, verb plus an object. Sometimes a subject with a predicate. In most of these examples, you would get 5 to 6 jumbled words. This is a compulsory question. From this section, you would get a compulsory question in the last example. This section carries 1 mark. Hope you understood all these jumbled segments, like your first year workbook examples. For more examples, refer some previous year question papers and arrange them meaningfully. Thank you. Bill.